Hi, I'm Rachel with Ally Safety, and this is our introduction to respiratory protection training. If you like what you see here, make sure to check out our full-length respiratory protection course that's linked in the description below. Here, I've made us a very rudimentary model of the lungs. You see, every breath we breathe, from inhalation to exhalation, transfers the air around us into our lungs, which then in turn diffuses the oxygen into the bloodstream. But if the air you breathe is contaminated, say with dust, chemicals, or viruses, you're also going to be transferring those contaminants into your body. Some contaminants, like asbestos or silica, might over time, like weeks, years, or even decades, cause scar tissue to build up on the lungs, restricting their ability to expand and contract, and reducing the lungs' capacity for air. While others may cause inflammation and occupational asthma. This can occur within hours, days, or weeks. This results in irritation to the mucous membranes, builds up phlegm, and causes the airways to be obstructed, limiting air transfer into and out of the lungs. While we want oxygen to diffuse through our lungs and into our blood, other substances that are harmful can as well, leading to symptoms almost immediately. That's where the respirator comes in. Serving as a last line of defense between our lungs and the contaminants around us in the air. The job of the respirator is more complicated than other personal protective equipment. It needs to strike the right balance of allowing air in but keeping contaminants out. The first step in protecting our lungs is identifying that there's a hazardous substance and then taking steps to prevent it from entering into our respiratory systems. The thing about respiratory hazards is that they can take a lot of different forms. To help you identify them, here are some of the most common.
Gases?
Mists? Vapors, essential oils, smoke, dust, oil mist. If you know you've got a respiratory hazard and you know how much there is, then you can choose a respirator. To use a respirator effectively, the first thing you need to know is how does your respirator actually work? There are two basic ways respirators keep contaminants out of our lungs, and they're actually both really simple. The first is by filtering them out. The second is by providing clean air from another source. As you might expect, different types of respirators offer different levels of protection. For lower levels of contaminants, you can use a filtering facepiece respirator, a half-mask respirator, or a full-mask respirator. For higher levels, you'll most likely use a supplied air respirator or even a self-contained breathing apparatus. Now let's quickly talk about filtering, cartridges, and why you can't just swap one respirator cartridge for another. Some respirators are pretty simple. The air travels through microchannels in the respirator, where the larger particles are filtered out and the oxygen gets through. While others might be kept away from your respiratory system by using a substance in the filter that attracts toxins at an atomic level, luring it away from your lungs. Still others may use certain salts to deactivate viruses or kill bacteria from respiratory droplets, neutralizing them when they come into contact with the respirator surface. These are simplified examples, but the point is, different cartridges protect against different substances. If you swap one cartridge out for another, just because they look similar on the outside, the function may be very different on the inside. Respirators are effective, but only when they're chosen and used correctly. Remember, always wear the right respirator and cartridge for the hazards present. That way, you're protected. Respirators can effectively protect your lungs for years to come, but they only work as well as they're chosen, used, and maintained. Take care of your respirator and it will take care of your lungs. To see more of our respiratory protection training, click the link in the description below. And as always, take care and stay safe. Hi, Rachel from Ally Safety here. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out the Ally Safety Toolbox Talk membership at allysafety.com. There, you'll find an entire library of videos that are created to make safety entertaining. I'll see you there at allysafety.com.